What's good, YouTube? It is Jerrell Fletcher from 3kingsboxing.com, and I'm here with a very special guest, 8-time champion, 2-division world champion, current undisputed women's middleweight champion, and a 2-time Olympic gold medalist, Miss Claressa T-Rex Shields. How you doing today, Claressa?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm doing good. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule. I know it's been a very hectic day for you, so we at 3kingsboxing.com are definitely appreciative of you making time for us to answer a few questions about your charity as well as some other things. I know that you're in Cleveland today. You've talked to over 300 students. Could you elaborate on what you told them? You know, being a big role model. You know, like I said, arguably the best women's boxer in the world today. What message did you relay to them to let them know that anything is possible as long as you work hard and commit to whatever it is that you're pursuing?
Well, today I'm at the Feel Love to Play 60 Summit, and I'm here with the Real Love Convoy, and we're here at a summit. It's about nutrition and physical fitness in school, and basically, like, they're trying to help end child hunger. And that kind of relates a lot to me, just, being from Flint and growing up the way that I grew up without having, food and nutrition. And all I really had was boxing, but I can still relate because there's a lot of other kids who I grew up with who went through the same thing. And so to find out that there's 1 in 6 kids in the U.S. that face, hunger, makes me want to get involved with it and bring awareness to it and let people know how they can, make that 1 in 6 number go down to 1 in 5 and 1 in 4. To make it, where less kids have to go through that.
I definitely respect that. That is definitely a great cause to be, participating in. How did you get started in it? I know you just mentioned that, you can relate to the kids of today because you were once in that position when you were a youth. So how did you, come across this, this organization, and what, sparked that connection in terms of, you bringing you on board?
Yeah, so I think it all started when I did a panel with Aaron Judge, Victor Cruz, and myself in New York. And from there, I met a lot of the Dairy Council people, and they were, very nice to me. They loved my story. I was the only girl on the panel, but, everybody loved me, and they loved my story and how I could speak and just my background of, who I was and how successful I am. Being a woman fighter, and then I got involved with Gen Youth, and then from Gen Youth, I ended up getting involved with, I joined the Gen Youth board, so I'm actually a board member of the Gen Youth, and that kind of led to me being with Fuel Up Play 16 and being a part of the Dairy Council, so that's where the connection started. But then just when you join something, you find out more about it, and I found out just about, how they help kids. They even helped me. The Dairy Council CEO Tom Gallagher gave $2,000 to my summer camp, and we used that money for the kids. I have a summer camp that I've been having for the last 2 months. We have over 100 kids now, and we're helping them learn ways to cope with anger, sadness, depression through physical activities, boxing, running, music, reading, and writing. So we're teaching them a way to express themselves without, when we get angry, people naturally want to fight, yell, and scream, but I'm teaching them a way to not do that. Like, if you want to go fight, go and punch a bag. if you want to go exert some energy, go and run. Just let them know, you don't have to be angry all the time, and there is different ways to express yourself. And if the bag and boxing stuff don't work and the running don't work, writing and music is also another outlet. So just teaching them a way to cope with things while they're young so they can deal with things when they get older the right way. And that's what my summer program has been about. And just with that, they just do so much for their community, and it makes me want to do the same thing for mine. So that's why I'm a part of Fuel Up to Play 16 and Gen Youth.
That's, like I said, that's great. And like I said, what better way or better name to have than you? You know what I'm saying? You come from those trenches. You can relate, firsthand. What these kids are going through. What would you say is the biggest obstacle, overcoming these situations that these kids, didn't ask to be in? What was your biggest obstacle, and what was the thing that really got you motivated outside of boxing, to really push forward and just be determined to keep pushing and making a better life for yourself.
Well, I try to tell everybody that, today can't be worse than what yesterday was, if you know what I mean. It can always get better, and I tell people not to dwell so much on one day. You have 365 days a year, and you'd be crazy to let one day ruin your whole year or ruin your whole month. You know, life is too short for that, and I always tell people to look forward to the future. I really didn't have any big, I guess my biggest obstacle was, trying to understand why I'm in a situation, but when you're a kid, you're like, you want, like, how come my parent isn't like this person's parent? And it can kind of make you feel bad, but I just kind of started telling myself, you know, God bless me with who my parents are and who my family is, and just to focus on myself, you know. So without me having to go through that, I wouldn't be the individual that I am today. You know, I go and get everything myself. I'm a hustler. I go out there and grind for it. I fight for it, and I win my fights, and I take care of myself and my family. So just with that, I always tell people to look forward to the future. You know, don't dwell so much on the past or, like, the day before, or, you know, take it too personal. Like, it was a bad day. Move on, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely. You being, like, not even just in boxing, let's put you on a worldwide, you being one of the biggest influencers, you know, whether it's sports or entertainment, how important to you do you feel that it's good for your fellow peers to also get involved with their community, you know, which in whatever way they feel to influence, you know, the youth as well? Because, you know, they say the children are the future. And sometimes today it feel like a lot of these celebrities, you know, kind of shy away from, you know, getting their hands dirty and actually going back to show these, you know, these kids that, you know, I'm just like you once were, you know, 10, 15 years ago. So how important is it not only to you, but people you talk to, you know, your friends in the boxing community or you know, in other, you know, businesses, that it is, you know, to spread the positivity and show?
It's all about what's in that boxer's heart. Like, some boxers don't have it in their heart to want to give back to kids. Like, they may think about it, mm-hmm. but when it actually comes down to, like, taking the actual action, you know, some people will, like, be like, oh, it's too hard, or it's too time-consuming, or I have better things to do. And I feel like in order for you to, like, give back, you have to really care about what you're giving back to. And I think that a lot of fighters don't, like, we don't have any other Muhammad Ali that I know about. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like people who genuinely love kids like myself, it's kind of like an easy thing to do, to be around kids, to help kids, to give your time to them. But some people don't have that kind of patience. Like, they want to show up, take a picture with a group of kids and leave. And that's not going to help their community. So I feel like, you know, it's not really, you can't force a fighter to be that way. No matter if they have the look or the face for it, it kind of got to be in your heart. Like, always with Anthony Joshua, he's always around some kids, always, you know, pushing them, you know, or whatever. So I feel like it has to be in your heart. So I really can't say much for other boxers.
Definitely respect that. Could I turn the subject a little bit? I know, you know, you're here to promote, you know, your event, which I respect, but I would, you know, people want to know about, you know, your fight upcoming, you know, with Ivana.
Yeah.
What's her last? I don't want to mispronounce her last name. Ivana Habazin.
Habazin, yeah.
Habazin. Right. I know you put on Twitter yesterday. There was a new date. Could you reveal that date, or is it not set in stone yet?
Oh, it's October 5th.
October 5th. Well, there you have it. You know, October 5th. It's still gonna take place in Michigan, right?
Yep, in my hometown at the Door Federal Event Center. Live on Showtime, baby.
Okay, and I know y'all had some back and forth. You know, once you pulled out with the knee injury, she, you know, made a video accusing you. I mean, I guess she was alluding to you being a little overweight, because a lot of people have been skeptical of you dropping down to 154, you know, making that, and you quickly fired back. Anything else you want to add to that, you know, that accusation? You know what I'm saying?
You know, well, it's the reason she's never been a world champ. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. The reason she hasn't been on top, because champions don't carry themselves like that. And, you know, as much as this sport is, or whatever it stands for, at the end of the day, like, my health matters. You know, after boxing is over with, I want to be able to run and play with my kids. You know, and I don't have none yet, but when I do decide to have them, I don't want to be like, oh, I jumped back in the ring, and, oh, I dislocated my knee, and then after I dislocated my knee, I hurried up to a quick recovery. so I could fight, and then broke my leg or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, it was a serious injury. And even now, I still have 2 or 3 more weeks of rehab, you know? So, you know, she didn't feel like I was taking or whatever the case may be. But I don't have to, you know, fake anything. Like, I'm 9-0, and I'm the undisputed middleweight champion of the world. If I was going to fake the injury with anybody, it would have been against Hammer. You know what I mean? Like, I would have pulled out of that fight. Like, a fight where people were actually counting me out, saying that she was going to beat me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And just in my career, I've already proven that I'll fight whoever, whenever, and I'll fight the best. So her just saying that kind of was, I think, more if she said it to upset me, but what she don't understand is that upsetting me is not the best thing to do. being who I am and the way that I fight. I'm not going to go out there and swing all wild, but I will put a little more, you know, a little more power on my punches to make her eat a word, for sure.
Definitely. I got a few more questions before I let you go. You were recently asked, I think it was a TMZ interview. I think you was at the ESPYs, and they asked you on your thoughts on Amanda Nunes, and you, simply knowing you, you know, you direct with it. You said that you would put her to sleep if y'all fought. Has that ever crossed your mind, not just particularly with her, but just looking at, you know, mixed martial artists, you know, female fighters? I don't know if you watch.
No, so you have to listen to the whole interview. I gave Amanda Nunes her props and told her in MMA, I don't think I could beat her.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't know anything about that sport. But when it comes to boxing, there's not a woman in MMA or boxing that can beat me. And that's just being honest. And then I said about me knocking her out because if we was to fight at 160, she's already too small.
Mm-hmm.
No matter how big her punching power may be against those girls who fight at 145 and 135, but originally a 168 fighter, so going down to 160, I still have the advantage, and going down to 154, like, I still have all my punching power from 168, so just with that, like, how can they expect her to just, you know, come in a box and have an easy time with me? That's not going to happen. Like, I would knock her out, you know, especially having to go 2 rounds, 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, 10 rounds in four for 2 minutes, it's a way faster pace than 5 5-minute rounds. You kind of get to chill out or whatever in MMA, but in women's boxing, you got to go. And I don't know if she could do that. I know she's had some stamina problems in the past, but, you know, all respect to Amanda Nunes, she is the GOAT in UFC.
Mm-hmm.
Hands down, she beats the best fighters like I have in women's boxing. I'm the greatest woman fighter, so that's just how I see it.
Would you entertain it if they came to you, I mean, and said, look, she was serious in a boxing match? Would you entertain that after you got through handling your business against potentially Cecilia?
If she wanted to fight me in a boxing match, of course I wouldn't. I wouldn't turn it down. But she's never made any inclination of that, and I haven't ever made any inclination of going to UFC. So
yeah.
Even though I'm the younger of us two, I feel like I still have a lot of time to decide what I want to do with my career. So I could possibly end up in MMA. You know what I'm saying? I could possibly do that because I had the time on my side to do so. But right now, I'm focusing on boxing. And if I do decide to do MMA, I'll, you know, let my Instagram know first.
All right, last question. I know both you and Cecilia Baracus both verbally or at least said y'all would like to fight each other. Has it gained any traction in terms of actual negotiations or at least communication from your team to her team? And is that possible for 2020?
I know that my team has reached out to her team, and they kind of entertain it, but it's like from her, what is her person name? Her promoter says that she doesn't want to fight, but she says she does. So it's kind of, it's really confusing, and but I don't know. It's never been up to the promoter to pick who fight who, but I don't know.
Well, hey, hopefully we see y'all two in the ring. Like I said, y'all both great fighters. Arguably.
Okay, so the lady I'm here with says one more question that I had, and then we have to go on to the next event.
Okay, well, that was it. If you like to, you know, let your fans know where they can reach you on social media, you know, you can do that right now.
Yep, on social media, my name is Claressa Shield, Claressa Shield, Shields, on all my websites, you know, all my social sites. And on Instagram and Twitter, I have the blue check mark. And on Facebook, I have the blue check mark too, but I'm not on that page. But I do have a page, but I'm probably about to delete it though, so I wouldn't follow me on Facebook.
Well, Claressa, I want to thank you again for taking time out of your busy schedule. Hopefully, we can do this again. I wish you best of luck moving forward October 5th, as well as with your charitable efforts, and continue to inspire, you know, the youth to be great or greater than you, and, you know, see you October 5th.
Thank you.
Thank you.